Hello, this is Jack from Teaching ESL Online. Now, today I have another Final Cut Pro tutorial for you where I'm going to go over some of the basics of color correction. And the first thing to note is that I am not an expert in this area, especially when it comes to professional color grading. What this tutorial is going to do is just go over what I have learned when it comes to correcting for color when it comes to uploading videos for YouTube or using on Facebook. So what I've done is I've imported this raw footage from the Sony A6400, and I'll leave a link to everything I use in the description, including some LUTs that we're going to talk about later. But we've imported this raw footage into here using color profile 1. Now, I'm not using one of the real raw settings on the camera because I found it was just a little bit too much for what I want to achieve for my YouTube video. So I just want things to look natural, but also just an edge on that professionalism too. Now, this raw footage that's been imported, it actually looks pretty good. It's not too far off. And it's also important to get it right at the start when it comes to white balance especially. So exposure level, so you're not blowing anything out. And then also the white balance, so then the color is right, because that's really hard to correct after the effect. So let's now talk about hotkeys. If I press Command 4, it brings up the editing panel on the right. If I press Command 5, it brings up your effects panel down here. And if I press Command 7, then it brings up the waveforms or the vectorscopes or the parades. And these are the three things that I like to work with. Now, I normally start by just putting a LUT on there. And I have downloaded a lot of LUTs in the past. And if you just actually, I'm just going to choose a random one just to see what it's like. PB Pocatello. Okay, so you can see here, that's a very strong one. And you can slide it down here to see the different effects to see how strong you want to make it. But the ones I like to use are these ones down here. Sometimes I do PS2, but I find that's a little bit light for me. I actually use PS6 at the moment. And these are LUTs that I match to Lightroom as well. So I always use these LUTs when it comes to Lightroom and also Final Cut Pro. And again, you can mess with the slider. Like at 100%, I think that's just a little bit over the top, but I like to do it around 50. And if you go from 0 to 50, you see the difference. And at any time, you can just click Effects just to see the before and after. I'm going to do more of that soon. So the next thing I like to do is to go here, and in the past I used to do the color board, which is this, but I much prefer color wheels now. And I don't do anything else. It's color wheels and LUTs. So it's not really too complicated this, but this is just the basic thing I like to do. Now, I use the waveforms over here on the left because it shows you where the shadows are and where the highlights are and where everything else is in respect to that. Now, I've actually exposed this pretty well to start with, and I'm using some good lights and in a studio where I can control the lighting and keep it the same every time. So it's not a mix and I don't have to do too much after the fact, but the light does change slightly because I don't have full control over the light in here. So what I like to do is firstly take the shadows and then bring them down so they just touch zero, and let's just look before and after, before and after. So that's just bringing in some more contrast. When it comes to highlights, I like to do the highlights so that the skin tones are around 75. Okay, mine are a little bit brighter, it seems, probably because I'm closer to the big light, but you can also just mess around with this too. Now, the issue we have here is the white coffee cup, because that is very bright, and I should remember not to use white coffee cups in shot. But I go a little bit off the waveforms, a little bit of what I just look at. I think I like it around there, okay? So it's around there I like it. And just to say at this stage as well, on the right is the different lights, so higher or lower, the strength, and on the left is saturation. Now, sometimes I actually do my own color correction with these curves in here, but I'm using the LUT today just to make it easier for myself and just to give it that tone that I normally like to use. Now, mid-tones, if you go up, it's blown out, go down, it's really contrasty. It just depends on mid-tones what kind of contrast you want to have. And I like to go around here. Let's see. Yeah. Just below. I always like to bring them down a little bit. I think that should be good. And then on the left here, we have global saturation. So let's just, I'll show you the extremes. I just messed with the saturation a little bit. That's obviously way under saturated. And then over here, obviously way over. And then I like just to mess around with it a little bit and see where I am. I think that about where it was to begin with. And then if we go back to this main board over here, we can see before and after. And obviously before looks a lot more washed out now. At first you look at it and you think, oh yeah, that looks okay. But once you do the effects, it looks better. And the key is as well is, whenever I first started with this, I used to always oversaturate it and over contrast everything. But I think this looks quite good. And then I like to just go through the timeline a little bit just to see what it looks like. I mean, my skin looks a little oversaturated, I think. The chair and the green in the background. But I think it looks pretty good, that, actually. My only concern is that the coffee mug is really blown out. It's just a little bit too much there. But that's okay. It's just a coffee cup. And then one last thing I like to do, just to double check, if you go to the Vectorscope, this is just basically what I've been taught is this line here, you want to get close to this line as possible because that's looking at your white balance. And I'll just show you some examples. You can go, if we go this way, you can see it's going way off the line and that's too green. It's too much of a green tint. If you go all the way over here, it goes off the line again and it's too much of a purple tint. And you can just double tap it to reset it at any time. But you can mess with it just a little bit to say like, okay, that's closer to the line there. And again, it's just a very subtle change, but I think it's a good one. And then again, I might just bring the saturation down a little bit. And if you're ever in doubt, what you can do too is do these settings, go away from it for 10 minutes and then come back and see it again. And then you can also look up some of your older videos or other people's videos and just contrast it to that and say, okay, is this oversaturated? Because it is quite hard to know while you're doing the edit. But I think that's close enough for me and the purpose for the YouTube channel. I like it just a little bit oversaturated in terms of if I'm gonna go one way, I want the colors to be vibrant and to be strong. But that's basically it for me. So I use a LUT. Let's just take the LUT off. I'll just show you this briefly. You can just see the difference there. I just love the, it's like the S curves that they use in here, the different types of contrast that they use just to bring it to that color. And I really like it. And you can just see that's like a, think of that as like an effect that you can put on top of things. But I start with the LUT, get the strength, then go to the color wheels, and mess around with those, mainly looking at the shadows to, again, I'll bring this up, to bring it down to zero. The highlights, skin tones, just play with it. Around 75 for the main part of the skin tone is good. Mid-tones, if you want to bring more contrast in, bring it down, okay? Command Z to undo that. And then saturation is up here to change the saturation. And sometimes, you know, you might just need to give it a global boost. You know, if you want to bring everything up like that, and then you can bring the shadows down here. It brings in a bit more contrast. And I actually quite like the look of that now. So I might just tinker with this a little bit more, but that's just a general overview of how I like to color correct using Final Cut Pro.